G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today it's time for another gaming life tips video. I want to talk about integrity. Now, you may be too young to understand it, but every day your experiences and your choices and your actions are shaping and defining who you are and who people perceive you as. The good thing is, if you're already on a declining path, you can change your outcomes today, and you still have so much ahead of you. In life, you will find tests. Not just formal government-appropriated ones for school, but tests in life that you don't even know were going on record, or that you don't even know that people were going to notice. Some will be small and insignificant, so small that people that you know won't even care. But some are really big life-defining moments, and you've got to watch out for them. You will have situations that will test you to the very core of who you are, and how you react to them is going to show your integrity. The definition of integrity is to be true to who you are, saying what you believe and believing what you say. Online these days, it seems like no one cares about integrity. Otherwise, normal people, with the benefit of believing that they are not being watched, noticed, followed, or tracked, will take part in situations where they meet other people who they don't know, but treat them in a way that you would never do in a face-to-face encounter. Everything from trolling and griefing in a video game, to running your mouth or threatening physical violence, even if there's absolutely no means to do so. Now, if you've visited my channel for any long time, you've come to know me. I'm an introvert at heart. I don't project myself out there too much. You've probably learned that I'm not quick to anger, but I can get angry like anyone else, you know, it's a human nature. I don't pick fights, but I will stand firmly for what I believe in. If there's some virtue or some happening that is a hill I will die on, I will fight to the end if I have to. Haven't had to yet. I've met folks in real life who only knew me from online interactions, and with the exception of being surprised by how I looked differently to what their mind's eye had painted, I was no different in behavior. Now, on the flip side, I've met a few folks online, and I remember the old early internet warnings about meeting people who you only met online, because they may not actually be who they project themselves to be. In the early internet, you'd use the comical warning, hey, don't get into a stranger's car if you only met them online, they might be an axe murderer. Well, nowadays we have an app to call a stranger to your house in their car so you can hop in. So, you know, do be careful. Not everyone out there has integrity. All of this gaming life tip is about being true to yourself, both online and offline. Your integrity will be tested, and you will be told that it does not matter. People out there in the world will be more concerned with your credit score than if you be true to yourself. But trust me when I say, there are folks out there with shining credit scores, but absolutely no integrity and no credibility to their name. Over my life, I have had the small tests that help define who you are. I passed the majority of them, and I failed sometimes. Like any test, it helps to study in advance. A little bit of self-reflection will go a long way. Think about these three rules to help. Firstly, do what is right, even when no one is watching. Second, make up your mind before you make a decision, especially when that decision cannot be undone. Thirdly, don't create a situation that makes the test harder. Now let me tell you about something that I failed. When I was young, maybe, let's see, it was 9 or 10, I can't remember the exact age, I was friends with some kids on my street who I thought were good kids, you know. It was one of those days after school, boredom had set in. We were playing in a nearby park trying to come up with something to do. Then the idea hit. We could go to a nearby store. and take a few things. Stealing is wrong. I knew this, even at a young age. The super stupid part is that it was late in the year. This was a time that was past my birthday, but not quite yet Christmas. So I had some birthday money from my grandparents that I could have had access to. But in my mind, I would have had to go ask my parents to use my birthday money, and asking them for candy was not gonna fly, so... They said that they had done it before. And the kids told me the method that they had used to get candy from a nearby gas station. Still, I was shy and introvert, and I knew it was wrong, but I was wanting to fit in, right? With nothing better to do with idle hands and active minds. So, knowing it was wrong, I went along mostly out of boredom, but, you know, I still didn't want to cross that line. And I said I'd wait at the park while they went and did their thing. But after a while, they did not return. I figured, what, had they ditched me? Was I that much of a stickler for the rules that I had lost some friends? So I knew the plan, and I figured I'd go see them at the store. Again, when I got there, they weren't at the store, but I imagined in my mind's eye that they were successful and they had maybe returned back to the park and I had missed them, or maybe they had ditched me altogether and they had reconvened at the house, so if I showed up empty-handed, that wouldn't be good either. So this was the defining mistake of my misadventure. My next mistake was knowing that it was wrong and going ahead with the plan because I wanted to fit in. It was such a double failure, and I was gonna pay for it. So I tried to take some candy by the method that I won't reveal to you all. I don't want to give anyone ideas. Let's just make out that it was stupid, alright? But I noticed that the man behind the counter hadn't noticed, and I went for the door. As I was almost out the door, a hand landed on my shoulder by another who had been watching on a closed circuit TV. They saw clearly as I had taken some items. They knew I had the items on my person. Alright, so I was a kid. I was a young kid. They asked for my parents' number. I gave it. My parents were called. Mostly because of my age and the pettiness of the crime, that nobody wanted the cops involved in this. My birthday money went out the window because my parents had no idea if this was my first attempt or one of many. I mean, all the store had as evidence was that they had been losing items. And they had me taking items, so, you know. A lot of my money from my birthday went into the stupid tax. I paid a stupid tax to the store in order to learn my lesson and to help them recover from their losses. It was way more than what I had taken. Now, the real question is, if at this stage I did not get caught, would I be the person I am today? I could have been laughing it up with my friends, and later I might have gone along for something bigger. Be careful of this just this once way of thinking. Many suckers have fallen for that line. You know, it's even become memed to death online, like meth, not even once, you know. Once you take that first step down the wrong path, the next one becomes easier. And that cycle keeps going. You know this. It's not an uncommon factor. It's pretty common knowledge. What's the Star Wars quote? Once you start down this dark path, forever it'll dominate your destiny. Sure, right now trolling your teammates might seem like fun. Cussing out your tank, your support, or your DPS, blaming them for the team failure may be true, or it may really be equally unwarranted. In recent days, folks have complained about my Sombra gameplay as I've been learning. And sure, occasionally, I'll do an EMP that got little value. But more often than not, when somebody has complained about my gameplay, I went looking at the replay at where I could improve. But then I also took a look at what the complainer was doing. and looking at their gameplay, you could call out equally bad decisions. The better games, however, are the ones where, despite the odds, our team manages to dodge several enemy ult pushes and still come out on top. Every day, try to make online experiences better for you and others. Keep it real out there, brothers and sisters. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you keep true to yourself and hold fast to your online integrity. It is human to get angry, and at times I lose my cool also. But so long as in your mind you know that it was wrong and you strive towards something better, the online community will improve. The biggest trick now is we have younger generations who have only known an internet with angry, anonymous people online griefing and trolling the heck out of them, and they could grow up to think that this is normal. It is not. We can combat this. We can fix this. We can be better online examples for others. And at the end of the day, isn't that what we all want? We want better games, we want better teammates, we want better interactions. We want to improve ourselves and improve others. I don't know, some out there may be on a downward spiral already and only want malicious harm upon others, but I don't. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.